Now we will discuss two types of homologies. That's called orthologs and paralogs. So by definition, an ortholog are two genes that are separated by a speciation event. And a paralog are genes separated by gene duplication event. So there is at least some theories and probably some evidence for it also that genes that are separated by duplication events in the paralogs are more likely, I mean, they would allow one of the genes to evolve a new function, or they can separate and become slightly different functions, something what's called subfunctionalization. However, orthologs in general should have a similar function because they are just doing the same thing in two different species. So if you identify the orthologs among the orthologs, you should be able to predict or identify the function of an unknown better protein gene better than if you define paralogs. And there are some evidence that put the pushing towards this direction, although it's not extremely strong. So as this is the concept, important concept, homology, as I said many times before, it means two genes have a common ancestor. Orthology means that these ancestors the homologs are separated by a speciation event. Paralog, as I said, is separated by gene duplication event. Then, of course, later it can be separated by a speciation event also. And then the synalogs, which actually means that things that are similar but without being homologous at all. So, if you think about this as an example, we have a gene alpha, we have two species. A and B. And in species B, you have the genes alpha, gamma, and beta, but in A, you have only alpha and beta. So you want to find a relationship between all the genes. So what happens is actually at one step in time, before this speciation occurred, you have an alpha protein that's duplicated to an alpha and beta protein. And then, because structure is slightly different, or it does something slightly differently. So directly after the speciation event, of course, you have A alpha, A beta, and in B you have B alpha and B beta. And then there is another duplication event in the species B, or the ancestor of the species B, where you have B alpha has been duplicated. So now you have B alpha, B gamma, and B beta. While in species A, you have A alpha and A beta. Also, what also happens is the genes are lost, so you can think about in theory you could have any losses. But if you look at 303, how long time has passed in these things? And most of it isn't when this B gamma and B alpha. And then what is most related to these ones is either B gamma and B alpha most related, is actually the other alpha protein. Because that was the same, that is the ancestor at the speciation event. So it means that they are A alpha, B alpha, and B gamma more similar to each other, then A beta, B beta more similar to each other. And these two groups, then the betas and the alpha, beta, gammas, are orthologous groups, not B, not So as to summarize, you have these homologs, so everything. Orthologs are the ones that are, in this case, alphas, and or the betas, and the paralogs are the ones, if you take an alpha and beta pair. So often what you try to do is you try to find some kind of cluster of orthologous groups. There's a database called COGS that is doing that. So you basically take a gene in species A and you find if the most similar gene in species C is, you find that one. And if that gene is also the most similar gene in species A also is the same gene, and you have these groups, basically you have pairwise relationship to find the most similar genes in every species. Then you actually have quite high chance that these are orthologs and they should do similar functions. However, gene loss might occur functions. So you can think about these three here. So this is how it looks like. It's the same as before, but you skip the gamma. And you have four species, you have A, B, C, D. And you have an alpha, beta gene. So there was duplication first before this is separated. And in theory, you should have an easy simulation. However, what happened is that in alpha and beta, one of the genes are lost and a different lost. So that means that if you do speciation, the species definition, this one, that actually means that the genes in alpha beta are more distant related because they go all the way up to the top than, for instance, the genes between A and C and D. So you would have a tree that looks like this. So this is the three genes. Alpha C, alpha D, alpha B, beta C, beta D, beta. It's the groups. But it would mean that you would think that alpha, A, the species A is more similar to C and D, and B is more, well, than it is to B, which is wrong. So if you only take this part of it, the species, you will end up having that. So you can try to do this by combining species of events. If you know the species of events and have data, you can go back to this example here at the beginning. You can reconcile and think, this must we believe it's impossible that centipus is more similar to humans than chicken are. So we can assume whatever if we have. So we can make a model that actually takes into account both the losses and gains. And basically we have one that looks like this. And it was by finding this little three duplication events. So if you do that, you take a number of genes in some animals, you found that there are about 5,000-7,000 core flaws. You have one copy in each of all these genes, suppose in fish. Toads and humans, and then you have a set of proteins that are have relationships, but they're not end to one. They have maybe several copies in one of them, or many copies in all of them. So, and then you have of course another set of genes that are homologous, but they're not. They're probably more like paralogs, or we can't define. At least it's not clear. They're not clear orthologous. So there's a clear set of orthologous genes that are saved between most animals. Another complication is what's called horizontal gene transfer. That means that genes that are moved between bacteria but not in evolutionary pattern. And particularly bacteria is a big problem. So basically you can't really trace back bacterial evolution on single few genes because they are there's also a risk that they've been transferred from somewhere else. As I mentioned, all similar not homologous. So this is the theory of days that you've tried for two proteins. Looks very similar, almost spot on. However, if you take the proteins together, they are completely different and there's no homology at all.